Well, now that it's over and you've officially run the table, gone undefeated, what does that accomplishment feel like? What does it mean to you guys?
Yeah, I think it wasn't something that we were necessarily shooting for throughout the season. We really just took it one game at a time. But, you know, it really kind of puts that exclamation point on our season. And it was just felt really good to top it off like that and kind of have that momentum and confidence going into the Summit League tournament.
What can you say just about what an accomplishment that is, too, given, you know, going into the season, USD was the team that was picked to win it. And you guys have obviously dealt with a lot of adversity with injuries and, you know, the COVID stuff, which obviously everyone has to deal with. But still, you know, it's been kind of a wild season for you guys to be able to run the table like you did. What do you think that says?
Yeah, I think it says a lot about our team. Like you said, like COVID, it really affects every team, but I think we did a really good job this year of, you know, staying pretty level-headed through all those situations. And obviously the injuries are really hard for any team, especially, you know, with two players like Maya and Tori. I think it really meant a lot for our team to have different people step up every week. Like you look at last week, having different people step up. And I think that gives us a lot of confidence going into next week.
I was just going to say, like, what kind of momentum now do you feel like you have going into the postseason?
Yeah, I think, you know, there's still things we can definitely improve on from each game. I mean, you look at these lineups that we're playing, and we've really only had those lineups for the last couple weeks. So I think really improving those things, and there's definitely a lot of things we can improve on this next week.
Andrew, you got anything?
Tylee, Madison was 3-for-4 from three tonight. She's really been shooting well now for the past 3 or 4 weekends. Just what have you seen in her development throughout the season?
Yeah, it's really good to see Maddie shooting the ball so well. I think we all knew she was a really good shooter coming in, and to see her have confidence, you know, and especially these last few weeks, and stepping up at these times is really special for her, and we're happy to see it.
Down the stretch there, they cut it to 4, and you guys got 3 straight defensive stops. What do you think led to those stops there?
Yeah, I think we've been in a lot of close games this year, and I think a lot of people stepped up in those times, just like we have had to do the last couple weeks. So we kind of were in a little rut there for a while, but to finish the game out strong like that was really good to see.
Yeah, what a heck of a way to finish off a long, you know, grind of a conference season. It kind of felt like that was kind of like our season is gone. You know, we've had to fight pretty hard to be in this position, and to go undefeated through the Summit League regular season is a great accomplishment for the team. Honestly, it's not something that this is probably the first time I've talked about it. Not once throughout this did I ever bring that up with the team. You know, I don't know if they did or talked about it on their own. If they did, that's fine. But, you know, I really feel like it was, again, a byproduct of just how we approached everything that was thrown at us this year. Just really tough-minded, really resilient. Everybody ready to step up and make plays. We're certainly a different team today than we were 2 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago. So, you know, there's been a lot of changes that we've had to overcome. And then some people have, you know, played to a really high level. I'm sure we'll talk about some of those players as we go on. But just couldn't be happier to see the team finish out this regular season with a win and do it at home. You know, it was a really kind of special several months to get to this point. So I'm really happy for the team. They have worked incredibly hard to be in this position, and it was a great day for us, but certainly a good win for us.
Aaron, there aren't a lot of things that your program hasn't done before. There aren't too many firsts for you guys at this point. Doing this for the first time, running the table, I mean, it is essentially just a bragging right or something. It doesn't come with anything extra, but what does that mean just to be able to finally to do something like that you've never done before?
Yeah, it feels great. It absolutely does. And, you know, we'll move on, start thinking about Sioux Falls here, but it feels great because it means that every time you stepped on the floor, you found a way to be, you know, at least 1 point better than everybody else you played. And that is incredibly hard to do. This game tonight was hard. I thought Kansas City played great. You know, they are offensively as good as any team in our league. They have the ability to make shots, penetrate, and do a lot of different things. And we had to withstand that and withstand a cold shooting fourth quarter on our part, a couple of turnovers, you know, things not going our way. You have to do that every single night, not just tonight, every single night. You've got to be ready to you know, overcome whatever gets thrown at you. And it's incredibly hard to do. That's why very few teams have done it. Something we'll definitely feel good about. But it's really been a byproduct of how they've approached everything all year. And that's what I'm probably happiest about, is they just have continued to fight and stay together and play for the right reasons, and this is a great way to reward those type of efforts.
Do you think your team has an at-large worthy resume if it comes to that?
I would say for the same thing I just got done talking about, as I'm asked about that in the past too, that's a byproduct of what we've done. I haven't looked at like the rankings, the net stuff in a while, to be honest with you. I know we've had a ton of top 100 wins. I mean, that's really impressive. And the net stuff it'll be interesting to see how that holds true, because there are some teams on there that are just probably, as a few weeks ago ranked in spots where it's like they just haven't even hardly played enough games. It's a little bit skewed. But looking at our team sheet, we don't have a lot of bad losses. We got a lot of really, really good wins. This team has handled everything that's been thrown at them. So I think they're in really good position. And we want to go and play well in Sioux Falls, and that'll be our only focus. But I think we're in a really good place right now. Proving you can play through some injuries, I think, is really important too. That doesn't necessarily just throw things into a different, feel. So, yeah, I think we're in a really good spot.
You talked a couple times early in the season about, or I should say maybe we talked about, your team's outside shooting, and it was inconsistent at times, it wasn't very good at times, and you pretty consistently expressed confidence that would eventually come around. Does it feel to you like it has, kind of just at the right time?
Oh, absolutely. How we've shot the ball in the last several weeks has been, I think, a difference maker for us in the season. Probably going back to that South Dakota game, that's where I thought we really started to catch fire and build some confidence. There is no doubt in my mind that that's been a driving kind of force for us here offensively. And I think it's happened for a couple things. One, just the confidence piece. People have stepped up and made shots. Two, I think our shot selection out there is a lot better. We're not just kind of living with that. That's not our first thought. I think we've played through different people in different areas and created some jump shots, which has been good for us. For a while there, it was just we were pretty quick on the trigger, and didn't really give ourselves a chance to do anything else. But we've had some people, quite honestly, off the bench. Haley now is in a starting spot, but she shot the ball much better. I'll talk about her in a second. But, Maddie has shot the ball better, to your point. And even though her role is still, not playing 30 minutes a game, her impact on where we are right now is phenomenal. Sid Stapleton's had some games where she's just really carried us for a few, stretches of knocking down three. So, our bench has been huge when it comes to that, and they've really made a big difference for us.
Coach, now that you played this weekend without Maya and you played a game against NDSU, how do you feel about your team heading into the Summit League tournament right now, as of right now?
Well, I feel good about it. I feel like we've got a good plan and what works for different lineups and different rotations. We'll probably continue to tweak and add to it this week. But I feel like the team has that, confidence that we can go out and play well. And that was really important for us after some injuries. Things are moving along with Tori. We still don't have an answer if she'll play or not, but she's in a much better place today than she was 3 or 4 days ago. So that's really promising, and I think that's a good thing. But I really like how our team is playing. This game today, we had several times out there, we had four players on the floor that are new to our program in a playing time role, whether it be Haley and then three freshmen and someone else, or we were using a lot of different people. And they were able to gain, I think, a lot of confidence these last couple weeks that I think can help them as we go down to Sioux Falls.
Coach,